All right, the legendary Green's theorem has appeared. So today we should be able to state Green's theorem, and we should be able to use Green's theorem to convert line integrals into double integrals. So let's go ahead and get started. Of course, the motivating question, is there any easier way, anything that could be done to calculate line integrals around the square from yesterday's notes? Or the line integral around the triangle from yesterday's problem set in a less painful way? And the answer is to use the following theorem. So let C be a positively oriented, piecewise smooth, simple, closed curve. So what this means is that the parameterization of C that you're working with should traverse C counterclockwise exactly one time. And let's let R be the two-dimensional region enclosed by C. So let's just get a quick sketch going. We get a closed curve C in the plane, let's call it this, which is being traversed counterclockwise. And then we have some region R, which is enclosed by C. So C is this one-dimensional object on the outside. R is this two-dimensional region contained on the inside. Now, if you have a vector field F, whose component functions are represented with P and Q, in that case, if you want to find the line integral around C of F, your vector field F, then that can be calculated by using a double integral over the region R. A double integral of what function? The double integral that you get by taking q and taking its derivative with respect to x and subtracting the partial derivative of p with respect to y. So if the vector field is not conservative, these two quantities will not be equal, and when you subtract them, you will have something there. They will not subtract to zero. If you integrate that something over the region R, then you'll get a number which is equivalent to the line integral that you would have gotten from line integrating the vector field F. Now, just as a heads up, you may also see the symbol where the integral symbol has a circle on it, which I've handwritten here, and you can see in the notes as well right here. And when you see the symbol, this is really just an emphatic way of really making the reader notice the fact that the curve C here is closed. And this circle in the middle is meant to evoke the fact that C is a closed loop and it starts and stops at exactly the same spot. Use Green's theorem to solve the exercise from yesterday's notes. So let's let f of xy equals negative yx. Let C be the boundary of the square, negative 1, 1, cross negative 1, 1, traversed counterclockwise. And previously I had added this extra stuff, but it really doesn't matter for us right now. So I'm just going to go ahead and erase that. Calculate the line integral of f of xy over C. This is the exercise that we did yesterday. It took 2 pages and 20 minutes for us to solve. But let's do it much more easily this time using Green's theorem. So here is our curve C, traversed counterclockwise exactly once. And that curve C encloses a square called R, R being the rectangle stretching from negative 1 to 1 in the x direction, negative 1 to 1 in the y direction. Now, Green's theorem says that if you want to calculate the line integral over C of f dot dr, then you can just as well calculate the double integral over the region R of the quantity that is formed by taking partial q, partial x, and subtracting partial p, partial y. Now, for this particular function, we have a q value of x, and we have a p value of negative y. So partial q, partial x is 1. And then we have partial p, partial y, which is minus 1. Now, this region, because it is a rectangle, is very, very easy to translate into a double integral. Because the topmost limit is just y equals 1, the bottommost limit is just y equals minus 1, and this is valid for x's between negative 1 and positive 1. So we can integrate as x goes from negative 1 to 1, as y goes from negative 1 to 1, the constant function 2. And since it is a constant function, it's extremely easy to integrate. Working on the inner layer, we get 2y evaluated from negative 1 to 1, which works out to be 4. Whoopsie, this is a 1. And then we have the integral of 4 with respect to x, 4x evaluated from negative 1 to 1, which is the value 8 that we found yesterday. Now, I have no idea how long this recording is, but I know it's not 20 minutes, not yet. And this calculation has only filled one page. And that's the power of Green's theorem. The power of Green's theorem is to take a reprehensible line integral, such as the one that we did yesterday, and the one that you did yesterday, and to turn it into an extremely simple double integral. And so you'll have the satisfaction of doing that same calculation that you did in yesterday's concept check, except this time Green's theorem is in play. All right, have fun.